Before the ending of this video, you guys will be knowing how to do push-ups in the perfect form, how to do them correctly in the perfect form every time, what are the benefits of doing push-ups in the perfect form, and what is the difference between the doing push-ups in the perfect form and the decent form, all together in one video called The Perfect Form of Push-ups, All You Need to Know. What's up guys, before we start, I am trying to hit 100 subscribers. We are having currently 51 only, we are halfway there, so make sure to click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so that I can hit 100 subscribers in no time. Let's begin with video. Alright guys, the area we are focusing now is our hands. In order to acquire the shoulder width apart position, you have to follow the following steps. Lift your one arm forward, curve your forearm inward and bend like this. After coming in this position, you will notice that your elbow is directly underneath your shoulder, and on the other side your fingertips is directly underneath the other shoulder. And here you will also notice that the distance between your two ends of your forearm is equal to the distance between your two shoulders. Apply this same formula when you are trying to get the shoulder width apart position. Both your elbows and your fingertips should be directly underneath your both shoulders, and also don't forget to mark the both ends of your forearm. Now place your hands at the marked position and you will find your hands at the shoulder width apart distance. The next area we are focusing on is the elbows. Make sure when you are doing push-ups, when you go down, your elbows should be at the angle of 90 degrees, and when you go up, your arms should be straight at the end of the movement. Yeah, like this. You can always go below 90 degree angle, and for example, if you are training, the below 90 degree angle would be perfect for you. The next area we are focusing on is our shoulders. Shoulders play a vital role, especially when someone is training with push-ups. Shoulders can either destroy your push-ups or can increase your strength in push-ups. If you are not leaning forward enough, you may be putting a lot of stress on the triceps and shoulders rather than the chest. In order to avoid this mistake, make sure to lean forward enough, keep your arms straight and then do push-ups. And also make sure you are leaning forward enough that when you go downwards, your forearm is completely straight. This will eliminate most of the stress on the triceps as well as shoulders and emphasize more focus on the chest. And when you are not leaning forward enough, your forearm will not be completely straight, emphasizing more stress on the triceps as well as shoulders. The next area we are focusing on is our back. Always remember, when you are doing push-ups, you are engaging all the pushing muscles in your upper body, which includes your triceps, your shoulders, your chest, as well as your scapula. Most people don't know about it, or they tend to ignore the role of scapula while doing push-ups. Now to avoid this mistake, make sure to push your shoulder blades down to activate your scapula at the end of the movement. This will not only help increasing your stability, but also make your scapula stronger progressively. The next area we are focusing on is the range of motion. The range of motion is the distance traveled by the body during any exercise. So the range of motion for push-ups will be all the way down to all the way up. Now I see especially beginners doing push-ups with the range of motion like this. Or this. Doing push-ups with the range of motion like this will not only kill your strength gains, but also slow down your progress. So make sure while doing push-ups, go all the way down and all the way up. The next area we are focusing on is our abs and glutes. These two muscles are responsible for keeping our body in a straight line while doing push-ups. Now see what push-ups look like without the activation of these two muscles. In order to avoid this mistake, make sure to activate these two muscles while doing push-ups to keep your body in a straight line. Okay, so you have mastered the perfect form of push-up. Now, the real question is how to do it correctly every time. It's so simple. Follow these 6 steps right after one another. Step number 1, hands. Make sure to place your hands at the shoulder width apart position by using the formula. Step number 2, elbows. Make sure while you go down, your elbows must be at the angle of 90 degree or below 90 degree, and when you go up, your arms must be straight. Step number 3, shoulders. Make sure to lean forward enough that when you go down, your forearms are completely straight, not tilted. Step number 4, back. Make sure to push your shoulder blades down to activate your scapula at the end of the movement. Step number 5, range of motion. Make sure to go all the way down and all the way up. This is the correct range of motion for push-ups. Step number 6, abs and glutes. Make sure to activate these two muscles at the same time to position your body in a straight line while doing push-ups. Now we are talking about the benefits of doing push-ups in the perfect form. Benefit number 1, the most important benefit is that it helps prevent injuries. Injuries are what that can cause permanent or temporary stop to your progress. So make sure while doing push-ups, do them in the perfect form to avoid injuries. Benefit number 2, it helps increasing strength. Doing push-ups in the perfect form helps increasing strength and bring back those strength gains. Benefit number 3, targeting the correct muscles. Doing push-ups in the perfect form or any exercise in the perfect form helps targeting the correct muscles that should be focused on while doing that exercise. Benefit number 4, doing push-ups in the perfect form not only looks epic but also is beneficial for your body. Benefit number 5, doing push-ups in the perfect form will help you build that strength which will take you to the next level exercises. For example, in push-ups, you can go from normal push-ups to the Superman push-ups. Three-finger push-ups, two-finger push-ups. Now, what is the difference between the perfect form and the decent form? It's so simple. The perfect form must be having all these 6 factors in it, while the decent form would have not. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell for more epic stuff. See you soon.